Morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to the beacon of light that is Unity of Birmingham. We are celebrating this first Sunday of April and this holy season. It is the 33rd day of Lent and the second day of Ramadan. So we're so glad to gather with all of you who are in the sanctuary and those of you who are online. So, I'm probably going to make a fool of myself. We're going to chant something that some of you don't know. But some of you do know it, and it's really simple. We're going to prepare for a time of meditation early in the service today. And we're going to start by chanting a Unity classic that says, I now let go, there's nothing to fear. And the second line says, the second stanza says, I now let go, I'm one with the one. So we're going to try this a cappella. Some of you know it. Please sing loud. Let's go. I now let go. There's nothing to fear. I now let go. There's nothing to fear. I now let go. There's nothing to fear. I now let go. I now let go. There's nothing to fear. Just like that. I now let go. I'm one with the one.
I'm one with the one. I now let go.
Your spine erect and your feet planted. I invite you to close your eyes gently, and we're going to continue to take some cleansing breaths, three deep cleansing breaths. And this meditation is about breath. So as you breathe deeply, fill your stomach, then your rib cage, and your chest, and breathe fully and release. Do that about three times really deeply. That oxygenates more blood vessels and makes your organs very happy. So breathing deeply, acknowledging that each and every breath we breathe is the life-giving, life-sustaining breath of God. I think of breathing as a joint venture with God, because we can take control of the breath at any time. But when we focus elsewhere, God keeps right on breathing us. It's a reminder of our union with the source of all power and all supply. Breathing is also a life-giving exchange with our plant family. As we breathe, the natural flow of radiant love, giving life as we exhale, and receiving life as we inhale, reminding us of the divine reciprocal flow of everything in life. Breathing consciously, we support our mental clarity, our emotional balance, our physical endurance, and our healthy attitude. We are so grateful for this simple yet powerful tool. taking another deep breath. We use this tune now for self-regulation and healing. Releasing all bodily constrictions and letting go of fear. Mentally, let's affirm, I am resting in the breath of God, and I know that all is well. And let us sit with that knowing for a few moments in the silence. Coming back to the room from the book of Job, chapter 33, verse 4. The breath of the Almighty God has given me life. Namaste, y'all. Namaste. So we're going to have more music from Arturo and Calliope.
Called the calibration song.
The way. Here's one that I wrote, and there's a sing-along at the end. So if you want to start singing along from the very beginning and making up your own words or harmonies or melodies, it's a collaboration. Every bit of music and every bit of breath is sacred in the time and space in which it's shared and with the people present. So thank you all.
Sample.
universal truth, I can imagine us waking up every day, learning how to love ourselves, our families, more importantly, that stranger on the street, giving him a smile, that's showing the love. So just like this, if you agree, we are all
to Unity of Birmingham. Come on, let's put our hands together for our online community. Real quick, do me a favor. Place one hand on your heart and another hand towards the camera. Repeat after me. Divine love, blesses you, and multiplies you,
and all that you have,
and all that you give,
and all that you receive.
Amen. 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 And so it is. We wanted to send you online, folks, a special blessing, because even though you are watching from home, you are definitely a part of our live service. And if you watch the service after we posted it live, we still honor and respect and bless you. And we thank you for your time and your attention. So this morning, how y'all doing out there?
Good.
Everybody's doing good. It is spring. Spring has sprung. Y'all want to have some fun today?
Yes.
We're still working with the theme of the Bible as astrology. Everybody say that with me. The Bible is astrology. Say that one more time. The Bible is astrology. And this month is Family and Friends Month, so we'll be scriptural, we'll be new thought, we'll be unity, we'll be all of these spiritual teachings that our ancestors have given us, just to kind of set the expectations of the house. I know y'all already know this stuff, and this is the stuff, I gotta say, that people whisper. So theologians, I just gotta give the secret. They whisper this stuff amongst themselves, but they never say it behind a pulpit. So if you're watching and you're a teacher, I challenge you, give the people what they really want. Don't y'all want this stuff?
Yeah.
They really want it. Besides, they can Google it, so they don't really need you anyway. Yeah, and that's the beautiful thing about our ancestors. They gave us this information, and there was a time where you couldn't say it without being chased out of town. Now it's all Googleable, because there's a scripture that says, in the last days I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. And the last day simply means it's not a time of gloom and doom. It's just, it's the end of an era. Everybody say the end of an era. Society grows up. We're no longer tribalistic anymore. We have a universal presence, and we're moving into other dimensions, not just on this planet, but there's also talk of things going on and terraforming and all kind of other conversations. So we're doing all sorts of things. Humanity is growing up. And so what we're feeling collectively is growing pains. Can we say yes to that?
Yes.
So today I want to talk to you guys from the topic of loving my neighbor as myself. Say that with me.
Loving my neighbor as myself.
Because when we look at this in a bunch of different ways, when we love our neighbor as ourselves, say that slow. Love our neighbor as ourselves. Did y'all catch that? You're loving them as if they belong to you. See, that's the juicy part right there. If I love you as myself, I'm saying that you are connected to me, so whatever happens to me happens to you, and whatever happens to you happens to me. Did y'all catch that? Loving our neighbor as ourselves. Because truly, we talk about God being one. Well, if I'm one with God and you're one with God, then that means you only meet no one but you. Tell your neighbor, everywhere you go, there you are. That's why if you move from one city to the other city, you still find the same people there, because the answer is you. Everywhere you go, there you are. Man, that one's talking trash about me. Man, that one's getting on my nerves. Man, I like that one. Man, I don't like that one. That's because you're important. You're a star. Tell your neighbor, you're a star. Stars got to be treated with respect. You're a diva. You're divine intelligence. And this is the truth. What's your constellation? What's your date of birth?
1126.
That makes you a
Sagittarius.
So instead of praying for persons, y'all need to pray for constellations, because this is the truth. There's some people y'all just can't get along with. We'll talk about that after service. This is God's house. We got to stay biblical. But this is the truth. And so if every soul, and Kenneth Grant said this, he said that every soul is a star. This is why we have a solar plexus, because the star of the solar plexus is the heart, right? Blessed are the peacemakers. Blessed is the pacemaker. You got to protect your heart. Place your hand on your heart real quick. Everybody say Jerusalem. Jerusalem is the city of peace. The Bible says in the book of Revelation that the prophet saw the city of Jerusalem coming down like a star descended from heaven in the form of a cube. If you unfold a cube, it makes the shape of a cross, a perfect cross, actually. Jesus was crucified on a cross. Your crucifixion takes place in this body. This is the tree where your soul is being hung. See, if anybody ever felt agitated in the body, annoyed in the body, uncomfortable in the body, a lot of our discomforts and stuff like that, they take place here, right now. And so your job is to go to the next phase of your evolution. Scripturally, Jesus didn't stop at the cross. We talked about a resurrection. So it's anytime you're uncomfortable, remember that crucifixion takes place in this body. It doesn't mean that this body is bad. There's nothing wrong with this body. But uncomfortability takes place sometimes here. And so whom the Son sets free is free indeed. So if I free my soul and free my spirit, then I can get on up out of this body. I can get on up out of this pain. I can get up on out of this irregularity. I can get up on out of this discomfort. And I can resurrect into my new life. I can resurrect into my new experience. Anybody ever gone through anything? None of y'all look like it. Walk through fire and don't smell like smoke. This is the inheritance that our ancestors gave us. So when we love each other as we love ourselves, we realize that there's only one self. Joseph Campbell said that there are heroes with 1,000 faces, but it's the same hero. There go my brother. Come on in, y'all. I'm going to ask about y'all. I do this old teacher trick whenever a person walks in when I'm talking. I just make them part of service. It helps my concentration. All of it is in divine order. Everybody say divine order.
Divine order.
But now, those are my brothers. We got to celebrate our brothers and our sisters and our young folks when they do come in. Because if we don't show them love when they come in the door, then they may not come back. So we love our neighbors as ourselves, because we meet no one but us. And if we are one with God, then we meet no one but
God.
Uh-oh, hello. Can I tell you something? The only devil that exists is the one you become. The Bible says that when the disciples were sitting around the table during the Last Supper, that Satan entered Judas's heart at this Last Supper, when it was sitting around the table. Because that's when discomfort comes in, when everybody's together. Then it's like, ugh, all these shifting personalities. This is why arguments hurt so bad, because when you think you're having an argument with a person, you're actually having an argument with the universe. There's an intergalactic war going on when you start arguing with somebody. My words are asteroids. That's why they hurt so bad. Boom, pow, Cancer versus Sagittarius. Boom, pow. We're destroying planets and planes of consciousness. I'm throwing iron at you and metal and stuff you've never even heard of. And pow, right upside the head. It's Aries versus Scorpio and Sagittarius versus Capricorn. That's why there's such a tornado that happens when people argue, which is why we have to return to love. Everybody say return to love.
Return to love.
Because that's the word. The work is returning to love, and the work is also finding love in the body. Because if there's discomfort in the body, and if I'm returning to love, then I win when I find love in this body. So I cancel out the discomfort. I'm able to find what they call self-regulation. I'm able to resurrect, get back on my square. Hello, somebody. Any Masons in the house? I'm able to get back on my square, and then I can speak truth to power. I can see you for who you really are, which is a divine creature, whether or not you may not be acting like that, or whether or not I perceive you to be acting like that. And this is the story of our life. We do this over and over and over again. Can I tell you something? You know, we look up in the stars outside at night, but if you look around the room, you're looking at the universe right here. You're looking at the three stars in Orion's belt. You're looking at Capricorn. You're looking at Cancer. You're looking at Sagittarius. This is heaven on earth. Tell somebody, this is heaven on earth. And it's right here. This is why Jesus said this. He said, the kingdom of God is at hand. Give me a hand. This is the kingdom. The kingdom of God is at hand. Give me a hand. It's right here. And we don't even realize it. You're looking at the stars. That's why you're so dizzy when you're around people. Oh my God, they're so beautiful, because you're in outer space right now. And the oxygen is, oh my God, you should have seen her. She was gorgeous. Oh, it's like my daughter told me, Dad, oh my God, I was trying to concentrate on what the teacher said, and this person turned around and looked at me, and I just melted. I was like, baby, I love you, but you're in fifth grade. Relax. They ain't that fine. I don't think they are. Who knows what the five-year-old, how many fifth graders sees. But so this is why we have work to do here on earth, you know, and to kind of speak frankly, this is why loving is so hard, because you're trying to love a God. You're trying to love a deity. And when you're loving a deity, deities require respect and adoration. I'm trying to wrap my arms around a constellation. Give me a hug.
That's right.
That thing is hard. Ask your neighbor, how big are your arms? How wide is your hug?
How wide?
Can you hug a constellation? When you hug your sister, when you hug your brother, you're not just hugging them. See, that name is the name that their mother gave them, but what you don't know is their soul coming down from the higher levels of the cosmos passed through a constellation and picked up a set of traits and characteristics which may make it difficult for you to get along with them. So guess what you got to do? You got to wrap your arms out further. You got to stretch wider. Tell your neighbor, stretch wider. Because I'm not just wrapping my arms around a person, I'm wrapping my arms around an entire universe. Do you know the names of the stars in your neighbor's universe? Do you know the name of the stars that are in your own universe? Do you know the names of the stars that are in your own belt? See, you got untapped power that you don't even realize. Your ancestors gave it to you. This is why in the, this is too revelatory. See, teachers are going to beat me up after this, because this is the stuff we talk about privately. But you know what? It's time to let the people know their wisdom. This is your secrets. This is your information. And this isn't secret teaching anymore. It's all Googleable. But when you know the names of the stars, this is why the Bible says that you have a name written on high that no man knows. Because you can't be in your humanity to know your true name. So you got to step outside of your humanity, which is the name that your parents gave you, and step into your divinity, which is the name that the stars call you. Did y'all catch that? Mm-hmm. In other words, there is more to you. You got another level in you. When you think you can't get along with this person, right? Then stop speaking to their humanity and speak to their divinity. Call them by their star. Call them by their constellation. Because when you call them by their star and their constellation, I don't have to say a word. I can just look up and talk to you. I can go find you outside. Ooh. See, that's what real prayer is. You know what Reverend Ike said? Reverend Ike said, when you pray, get off your knees and get on your feet. Prayer is what I say about myself to myself. So we don't pray to God, we pray from God. But we first have to find God in the self and then speak. Because when you're a child, you ask. But when you're an adult, you go get it. Because when we grow up in the spirit, it's about responsibility. The answers of God are what? Yes and yes. So when we grow up, we ain't asking for things no more. We just go get it. And if it doesn't work out, it's our choice because we are divine creatures. Tell your neighbor you're a divine creature. So what does that have to do with loving your neighbor as yourself? When you study the New Testament, there are three types of people that Jesus talked about. Talked about loved ones, which is filial, talked about neighbors, and then he talked about enemies. Those are the three types of people that you'll meet. And sometimes your neighbor is your neighboring star, but that's too astrological. Y'all don't want to hear all that stuff. Your closest star is your neighbor, right? Are you around your closest star? Let me ask you this. Is your life filled with the constellations that you get along with? Is your life filled with the constellations that you're most compatible with? Many of you that are listening to this message right now are missing out on joy in your life because you stacked your deck with stars that don't match. Yeah. Ouch. I shouldn't say that. But here's the responsible piece. Because you are God, you can build a universe and change the location of that star system. That's the power that's within you. Because where the North Pole is today, 10,000 years ago, that wasn't where the North Pole was. So stars can change location. Tell your neighbor stars can change location. So you got to be aware of who you are in order to command the world that you're in. See, when you realize who you are, nobody needs to tell you anything. That's why Jesus said in that self same hour, the spirit of truth, when the spirit of truth come, because they that worship me must worship me in spirit and in truth. So something in you wakes up to who you really are and you stop going back and forth with people. Because there's something called divine order. Everybody say divine order.
Divine order.
See, if I get in divine order, God takes care of it. That's why God says, vengeance is mine, I will repay, saith the Lord of hosts. This is also why Jesus says, pray for your enemies. Say this with me. Pray for your enemies.
Pray for your enemies.
Do you know what that word enemy means in Greek? I'm almost done. the word enemy in Greek means opposition, just like Satan. Satan is Hasatan in Hebrew. Hasatan isn't a person, it's a personality. It's somebody that causes strife or division. Like that person that comes over for dinner during the family reunions and they always start and stuff. That's a Hasatan. It's a personality. You can put it on just like clothes and you can take it off. You can embody that. When you get in your feelings and you want to give people a piece of your mind, you stepped into that energy because that's what it is. Just like everything else, it's an energy. Positive, negative, neutral, that's the spectrum. You are the neutral energy. You can move towards God or move away from God and move into something else. Everybody say devil.
Devil.
D-E-V-I-L. That's devil. Spelled backwards is L-I-V-E-D. See, it's live. It's the same spectrum. See, you are the pillar. You can go to the left or you can go to the right. It's not spookism and it's not boogeyman stuff. This is about your power. So when you own your power and step into your responsibility is children of God, heirs and joint heirs with Christ, the Christ consciousness, you ain't gotta do all the work that you're doing. Who's tired of going back and forth with people? Some of y'all are like, nah, I divorced them a long time ago. I don't go back and forth with nobody. But this is what happens when you own your power. So enemies, everybody say enemies.
Enemies.
The word enemy in Greek is just opposition. So Jesus says to pray for those that oppose you, because if you're in divine order, anything that opposes you isn't going to cancel you out. In fact, it's going to promote who you are. The greatest evangelist in the New Testament was Pontius Pilate. You know why? Because according to the mythology, when Jesus hung on the cross, he put Jesus, King of the Jews, in three languages so that everybody could see it. So your enemies are actually trying to promote you. That's why the word Judas in Greek means praise, because the opposite of praise is criticism. Judas wasn't the betrayer of the Christ. Judas was the revealer of the Christ. So your Judas is your revelation. Your Judas is your revealer. Your Judas, you may think, has come to criticize you. They've actually come to give you praise and confirm that you're on the right track. See, this is the wisdom that your ancestors have left for you. But they just left it in clues. What I'm doing on Sunday mornings is I'm giving you the cipher. Tell your neighbor, you got it now. This is why Jesus said, I and my Father are one. He said, if I go away to prepare a place for you, that where I am, you may be also. In my Father's house are many what?
Mansions.
Those mansions are the houses of the zodiac. Those are the mansions. See, all of you are living in various socioeconomic places. You don't realize you do have a mansion in the sky already. This is why you have to be reminded of who you are. Because when you are reminded of who you are, that divine intelligence, you make heaven on earth. My mansion in the sky is 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 stars high. And so you manifest that level of consciousness on the earth. Because if you are born a God, then you act like a God. So my question to you is, how does a God act? How does a God behave? How does a God talk? How does a God walk? See, that's spiritual responsibility. So when Jesus says, love your neighbor as yourself, that's easy. I'm loving you because I'm loving myself. So when you are acting out of character, right, all I have to do is find a place in me where that exists and cancel it out. So if it's not in me, can't be in you. So I'm not at fault for what shows up in my world. I'm just responsible for it. Because if I am the God or the deity of this universe called Cancer, born in 1987 in Sumter, South Carolina, then I decide who comes in and who goes out. Tell somebody, take control over your space. Take control over your space. Divine responsibility is what your ancestors have left you. You have the power to do, to be, to have, in the words of Reverend Ike and Catherine Ponder, in ways that you cannot even imagine. All I'm doing is giving you your spiritual autobiography. I'm telling you of who you are in case you've forgotten. So every time things show up in your life that looks opposite of who you think you are, you can go back to the truth you know, and you can speak it, and it shall come to thank you guys for listening. Mm-hmm. Namaste.
Unlocking the mysteries of the universe. And, you know, you invited us to go back to the Bible because you said it's all
yes.
in there.
Yes.
And I want to just share, I was looking for this. I might not be able to share it because I can't quote the Bible without looking. Anyway. It's related to, it's Matthew, I think, chapter 19, and it's related to the 12 thrones mm-hmm. judging, but we'll sit on the 12 uh-huh. thrones judging the 12 tribes of Israel. Uh-huh. And it's also the scripture reference for Unity co-founder Charles Fillmore's book on the 12 powers. Uh-huh. And so everything you're saying is reminding me of all of that.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
And so I thank you for reminding and inviting us to go back. You know, but even if I read the Bible at home, I gotta come in here so you can explain to me what it's talking about. I need help. So we love Unity and we love supporting Unity. We're inspired by the Unity teachings. And Peggy wants you to know that we have to work on this fire extinguishing system in the kitchen so that we can have gatherings, potlucks and pancake breakfasts.
Yes.
So please prepare, as we prepare for the offertory affirmations, please consider that. And we're gonna do the affirmation together. Divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, all that I receive. And I give in love, and I trust God, and so it is. So there are two bowls in the back of the sanctuary, and you can go online to unitybham.org. And I want to make sure that's .org and not .com. It's unitybham.org, and there's a giving tab, and you can donate there as well. So, don't forget to take a look at the website. We've got a brand new look. We've got the online newsletter and website. And all of the class information is available there. You can also sign up for Breeze to stay informed of what's going on at the church. And it is Friendship Month, as Reverend Jesse mentioned. So next Sunday, which is April 10th, be sure to bring a friend. We'll have some appetizers. You can also bring your favorite dish and desserts. And we're going to be on the terrace. I'm not sure where the terrace is.
Over
by the driveway.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
By the alley. Okay. Yeah. All right. And on Holy Saturday, April 16th, it's also Repair the Fence Day. So we're gonna come help George and others. George, what time does that start?
8 a.m.
8 a.m. Get up bright and early, like an Easter bunny. get a little warm up. Okay, so we're going to get the fence repaired on Holy Saturday, and then on April 24th, we'll have prophetic insights with Reverend Jesse after the service, and I think you'll sign up that day
with Miss Peggy.
With Miss Peggy before or during the service, perhaps, mm-hmm. And then that'll determine the order for those sessions, and they're 15-minute consultations. So I think that about wraps us up. I don't think I missed anything. So we're going to end with the peace song. If you'll all stand.
Be sure to meet my friend Calliope Pettis. She's in the Birmingham tour from Florida. And she will be with us also next Sunday. So this is time to greet her. She has her albums, you know, online presence. She's a wonderful, beautiful woman and a good friend, a spiritual friend.
Manifestation of healing in her life.
Hey.